Hi, I'm William Smart. My practice is Smart Design Studio, and we're a firm of about 45 people who create projects which embrace architecture and interiors as one. I approach design of our buildings from the inside out, and I'm always fascinated with what spaces we can create internally. And as a process, I try to not start the architecture until I've worked out the potential of the internal spaces. When I design, I feel like my brain becomes completely saturated with that project. And to mull it over and to release, I like to run. I run every day. And in my runs, I think about it and I start to uncover the problems. And then I'll go back and I'll work on it and I'll find myself stuck again. So running is my kind of savior for how I manage it personally. What I'm looking for is generally the purpose of a building. What we seek to do is do something that is exceptional or has a very special quality. Now that takes a lot of energy. My theory is it's probably twice as much work to do something exceptional as something very good. There's a lot more work. It's sort of like being an elite athlete in a way. They have to train much harder than a very good athlete. My personal philosophy that I try to instill in my whole team here is to ask for what you want. And don't be shy to ask for what you want. So I don't think that necessarily gets you what you want, because the strike rate is high. You know, often people will say no, but that's okay. But never be shy to ask for what you want. So if you think that the building should be made from concrete and be taller than the height limit, then go to council and say that. That's what I think it should be, and this is why. And don't be shy to ask for that. I'm mostly inspired by sculpture and also by designs of things that move. So I love boats, yachts, cars, planes. And what I love about them is the great cars or the great planes is how they embrace technology and evolve all the time and are improving in their efficiency, in their comfort, in their safety, in the way they consume resources. It must be beautiful, and it brings all those things together. So I find that fascinating and really interesting. And with sculpture, it's not about the technology, it's about the beauty of light and shape and how that works. So I'm very attracted to sculptures from the 60s and 70s that are really gutsy and strong and simple and unpolished. I like sculpture that is raw and